There's been no love lost between Apple and Facebook, Meta. Both companies have disagreed vehemently across the controversial lines of consumer data privacy and royalty fee collection in recent times. This feud, which has been in place for nearly a decade, is now set to move to an imaginary realm within our world called the Metaverse. Join us as we count the scores of this brewing contest between Apple and Facebook. As part of our conversation, we'll go over the following points. What is the Metaverse? What is Facebook's Metaverse? What is Apple's Metaverse? Who are the other competitors in the space? And at the tail end of this video, we'll discuss the one question on everyone's lips. Who's winning the Metaverse race? Long before this virtual reality showdown in the Metaverse, both companies had been at loggerheads, with Apple CEO Tim Cook and Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg firing verbal shots in opposite directions on several occasions. Tensions peaked in 2018 when, according to The Times, Cook's comments about the Cambridge Analytics scandal infuriated Zuckerberg so much that he ordered all iPhone users on his management team to ditch their devices in favor of Android. Consequently, Facebook released a statement denying the claim by The Times, but it didn't do much to quench the feud. Tim Cook has consistently criticized our business model, and Mark has been equally clear he disagrees, so there's been no need to employ anyone else to do this for us, the statement read. However, another section of the post appeared to confirm The Times' report and take a subtle dig at Apple, escalating tensions even further. We've long encouraged our employees and executives to use Android phones because it's the most popular operating system in the world. You've got Tim Cook in the red corner, who believes Facebook's ad-oriented model is a cause for worry as it compromises consumers' privacy. I think everyone has to ask, how do companies make their money? Cook said in 2014. If they're making money mainly by collecting gobs of personal data, I think you have a right to be worried, he added. At the other end of the ring in the blue corner, Mark Zuckerberg argues that the annual levy paid to Apple by creators on its App Store hinders the industry's growth. I've been pretty vocal that I think some of the App Store policies hurt the creative economy, especially during COVID, taking a 30% tax from small businesses that have had to move online. It's tough, Zuckerberg told Silicon Valley News expert Casey Newton. Apple claims it is fighting to give consumers absolute control over what happens to their data. Facebook says Apple is ripping off creators. But who really is the saint? Based on the fact that Apple abandoned its strict consumer privacy stance to introduce a new feature that deletes child exploitation content, experts argue that the device manufacturer is guilty of the same offense as Facebook. According to Professor Gautam Hans, an expert on First Amendment law and technology policy, the rift between these two Silicon Valley giants is more about control of the industry. Apple is a company very focused on controlling its own products and services, and they view Facebook as undermining that, Gautam said. Apple demonstrated that it could do more than just talk when it released the iOS 14.5 update, which included a feature that allows users to choose whether or not to share their data. And now, Facebook is pulling its own strings too, as it claims to bring the Metaverse to life. The social media firm also said it will effectively transition from being a social media enterprise to being a Metaverse company. The biggest indication that signifies the company's ambition to tap into the offerings of the augmented reality world called Metaverse. Of course, Apple is well aware of this plan and could spoil the Facebook Metaverse party even before it begins. What is Metaverse? Metaverse is a tech-based immersive virtual reality world where humans can live, interact, and have fun, just like in the real world. Facebook's Metaverse. As part of its efforts to dominate the Metaverse, Facebook, Meta, paid $60 million to acquire the sole rights to the name Meta from a South Dakota bank named MetaBank. But it doesn't end there. The company plans to invest $10 billion to invent technologies that will power the Metaverse in the coming years. Meta launched Horizon Worlds, a free virtual reality online game available to adults in the United States and Canada. Users can access this immersive augmented world using the Oculus virtual reality headset, a technology Meta purchased for $2.3 billion in 2014. But the company's goal for Metaverse is much more advanced than what is currently obtainable on Horizon Worlds. Future iteration will combine Portal smart display, AR display and smart glasses to make Facebook's Metaverse irresistible for users. Our hope is that within the next decade, the Metaverse will reach a billion people, host hundreds of billions of dollars of digital commerce, and support jobs for millions of creators and developers, Meta CEO Mark Zuckerberg said last year. What is Apple's Metaverse? From its 3D graphics API to the newly invented Apple AR/VR headset and its human interface devices such as the iPhone, Apple Watch and Apple TV, not to mention the M1 chip and Apple Digital Map, the consumer software company is well equipped to disrupt Facebook's metaverse agenda and install itself as the industry's leading force. Defiant's ETF Chief Investment Officer Sylvia Jablonski predicts that Apple is going to be a big player in the metaverse. Apple CEO Tim Cook admits that AR is a core technology that excites him, but he also emphasized that humanity has to be at the center of the company's metaverse campaign. Right before we discuss the other competitors in the metaverse, if you've made it this far, make sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Who are the other competitors in the metaverse? Tencent, the Chinese social media and game conglomerate behind PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, Crossfire, Dungeon Fighter, and G-Kart, could be one of the biggest forces in the metaverse. There are over 3.5 billion players on these four virtual reality gaming platforms combined. That's over 500 million more than the number of users on Facebook. Tencent is also responsible for WeChat and QQ, two social interaction applications with almost 2 billion users between them. Apparently, Tencent already has the infrastructure to support its entry into the metaverse long before Facebook or Apple even conceived the idea. We have a lot of tech and capability building blocks that will allow us to approach the metaverse opportunity through multiple pathways, Tencent President Martin Lau said. Although not as big as Facebook, Apple, or Tencent's metaverse campaign, other companies are pushing for a stake in the metaverse. One of them is the American tech giant Microsoft, through its Minecraft game, which has been hugely successful. Others include Fortnite, Roblox, and Silicon Valley heavyweight Google. Crypto-related metaverse platforms like Decentraland and Axie Infinity cannot be ignored. Judging by the number of established firms vying for supremacy in the metaverse and the success of recent events in the space, you can't rule out more companies joining the race. Who is winning the metaverse race? Based on the information revealed earlier, you've got to admit that Tencent would be the undisputed champion of the metaverse, but until it officially enters into the space, its robust infrastructure counts for nothing. For this video though, our attention is fixated on two heavyweight players who have made known their intention to dominate the metaverse, Apple and Facebook. Facebook seems to be winning the publicity side. Experts believe Apple is on track to leave every other competitor in the dust. A team of analysts from investment-backed Morgan Stanley say Apple will be a catalyst for augmented reality when it decides to enter the market with consumer glasses. They also added that Apple is likely to leapfrog Microsoft with its augmented reality glasses, as well as Google and Facebook. Apple gathered 35% of votes to edge Samsung, Amazon, Microsoft, and Facebook. In a Harris poll about augmented reality and virtual reality, some consumers have complained about the high cost of VR/AR headsets, which is why Facebook's Oculus headset currently sells for $2,999. However, Apple has found a way to beat Facebook in this category as well, with reports indicating that its base models will cost around $1,000. Consumers will find it even more difficult to resist the metaverse. The metaverse is not only the future iteration of the internet, it is a virtual world that could become our reality in a few years to come. Some say it could outrightly replace physical interaction. In contrast, other people like Google's CEO Sundar Pichai believe finding a balance between the metaverse and the real world is the way to go. Do you agree? Let us know in the comment section. Be sure to check out this video over here, sneak peek of a day in the life of Mark Zuckerberg.